The word grind to me, it's like dedicating yourself mentally, physically, because, you know, grinding towards something, grind is always like towards something in my head. Grinding towards something is, you know, it's a physical thing, it's also a mental thing. And I think it's also, as well as, like I said, dedicating yourself to something, it's having that willingness to want to exceed your limits. So grind as a word is like, yo, that maximum potential to reach the pinnacle, the max, the top. My motivation, you know what it was? I had my little daughter now, and it's something where I held my daughter and I looked at that girl and I swear, I said, you know what, I'm not going to make her suffer. I'm not going to make her, you know, come into this world where I can't provide her something as a parent. Like, if my daughter comes to me and wants to go to university or she wants things, I want to be there to also help her, you know, mentally but also financially as well. And I feel that boxing is something which gives me that opportunity. Of course, you know, I want to make my loved ones around me proud as well and happy. But my main motivation, my why in boxing, has always been my daughter. You know, you as parents, you as a dad and whatever, I think my role as a dad is to ensure her future is bright. And, you know, we all had dads who should do that themselves. And that's just, you know, that's how life is, man. I believe just, I take it upon myself anyway, as her dad, to say, you know what, I'm going to make her have a bright future. So if boxing's the way I can do it, boxing's going to be the way that I'm going to do it. When I first started boxing, I had a lot of people say the usual, oh, what happens if you get knocked out? You know, I don't know, like, you're a fighter. Because I'm a very calm person. I'm not like this guy who goes around and carries myself. Like, I'm a calm person, you know. People look for someone to then say, oh, you box or whatever. It's for them to find out, because I'm not the kind of person to be like, yo, I'm a boxer and try and carry myself hard. No, I respect every human being. But it's funny because we live in a society where a lot of people put their negative doubts, because they can't do it, on you. And it's like it makes them feel good about it. I don't understand why, but it's like it makes them feel good about it. So honestly, critics, I laugh at them. At the stage of my life, I laugh at them. When I was 80 yard plus in the rankings, just starting out as a professional, none of these will think I'd be in the top 10 or sixth or English champion, about to be the British champion. So, you know, what can you say? I'm sure Mike Tyson, I'm sure Mayweather, I'm sure all these guys coming up are critics. No one just gets placed there. You know, it's not a holiday camp, man. It's never been a holiday camp. We recently was in Dubai for my last camp, and people would be like, oh, Dubai, plush. But listen, the only thing I see in Dubai was the buildings. You know, when I was out there, if we were training 3 times a day, it's just that we're training in hot heat to get used to, you know, a more hostile environment. And and so my day to day, it's 3 times a day training. Most people can't even train 3 times a week. You know what I mean? In this day and age, people don't go to the gym 3 times a week. So you try training 3 times a day. It's a lot on the body, but it's something where if you manage your body right, you're eating the right things, you know about your foods, and it's knowing your body as well. Belts are nice, man. They look good. And obviously, I'd want to be a world champion, because it's something where my daughter can grow up now and say, oh, you know, my dad's English champion. My dad's probably, you know, British champ. My dad is a British champion. My dad's, you know, he's a world champion. So that would bring a great feeling to me to know that she can say those things. You know what I mean? My mom says those things, you know, my loved ones, all that. Everyone around me can say them things. It's really good, you know what I mean? So it's something where, until now, I only could talk on the feeling what I've got now. And I'm an English champion, so right now, that's the pinnacle. That's where I'm at right now, sorry. But for me, the pinnacle would be definitely be a world champion. And just be healthy, man. Keep all my faculties and my daughters happy and all that, and my loved ones, and that's it. It doesn't, honestly, the way I'm at now, it doesn't matter what other people want to think apart from my loved ones. You know, that's all.